So in this video, we are going to look at the properties of the function generator module that will provide the signal source for our experiment after passing through the electronics of the quantum analogs device. So we are going to look at the output coming of the output of the function generator. Look in channel one of the oscilloscope. So can turn on the function generator. You see that this is producing a sinusoidal signal measured with peak-to-peak voltage of 2.08 volts. So this is the amplitude from one peak of the sinusoidal wave function to the other. We can see that we have different choices for shapes of the signal. We could have square pulses if we want, or these triangular pulses. We're going to stick to the sinusoidal output, I think, for all the measurements, unless you want to try something different. And then out of the different things we can change, we're going to ignore the duty cycle, CMOS level, or DC offset, and essentially concentrate on the use of the frequency. So here we can select, there are two knobs to select frequency, and there is then a few buttons where we can change the range from 5 up to 5 megahertz, spanning the full range of the signal output. And there is another control, is the output level. This one changes the amplitude of the signal. So now we have a 3.6 volts peak to peak. So the smallest value is around 2 volts. There are ways to make it even smaller using this attenuation. It's 20 decibels of attenuation. So we have a wide range of possible amplitudes of the signal. But now let's look at the control from the frequency of this sinusoidal wave. For reference, the scale is 5 milliseconds between two divisions in the oscilloscope. So we have total 50 milliseconds full scale for the oscilloscope. And we get a measurement out of the function generator also. According to this, we have a frequency of 169 hertz at the moment. And we set the range at 500. So if we go to the smallest value of the coarse frequency control, this tells us that it is 45 hertz. And if we move it to the maximum, this tells us that it is 526 hertz. And you can see that the fine control, now the fine control is at the maximum value. We can move it to minimum. And it's a smaller fine control, of course. Has a smaller range of variations for a given setting. So, at the minimum for this particular value of the coarse, gives us 261 hertz. And if we move it to the maximum, that goes to 289 hertz. We could also attempt to measure this, not with this output, but check it with the oscilloscope. So if we take the select the measure menu, go to channel one. We can select to measure the period and also the frequency. So one should be the inverse of the other. So we see that for the value of 289, according to the precision function generator, we get a same measurement of 280, between 288 to 289 hertz in the measurement with the scope. We now try the both ends of the range for the setting. We have 45 hertz according to the function generator, between 44 and 45, and 44.3, 44.5 for the scope. And if we move to the other end of the range, we have a value of 585 according to the function generator and 584.7 according to the scope. So they are in good agreement. And finally, we can see what happens when we change the range. For example, we are now at 500 hertz, and the frequency is 331 hertz here. So if we go to 5K range, that should multiply by 10, the frequency. So this is little increase. It's having a bit of a issue finding the right value, but yes, but we have 3.29 kilohertz according to the function generator and 3.29 kilohertz also according to the scope. You can change the range from 5 milliseconds to 500 microseconds. And now it's happier and finds a frequency in agreement with the output of the function generator. So we look at the two ends of the spectra. The smallest frequency is the order of hertz. So we have to have a wide time window for our scope. And we see the smaller we can get is this. We could measure it with a cursor. Look at time. The maximum of this is here. The time between these two is what we have over delta t, 2.5 seconds, which is close to a frequency of half a hertz. So we can have a 1 microsecond, so 10 microsecond range for the full scope. And we see that if we put the maximum frequency, and we just attempt to measure the frequency, just remove the we measure a frequency of 5.5 megahertz, or let's increase the scale to get a better measurement. So 5.5 megahertz and 5.5 megahertz also measuring with the function generator. So this is our maximum possible value. Can increase it a bit more by increasing the fine frequency control. So we get almost 6 megahertz of maximum frequency.